Shaper can also create sketches that intersect with geometry. Let's create our geometry. I go to top view and sketch, circle. I create a circle with a radius of 30 millimeters. So 60 is the diameter. Then I zoom out a little bit and exit the sketch. The profile of the sketch I extrude up by 30 millimeters. And then I would like to core this out. I select the top face, go to shell, and shell this by 5 millimeters. Very good. Think about this as a small container. And now we would like to create a lid that fits perfectly on and into it. Here again, I go to the front view. So the grid is nicely aligned with my view and perfectly goes through the body. I go to sketch, I rotate my view, and there you see again the snapping points where we have hard edges of my geometry. With the line command, I can now draw a line from point to point. Press escape. Do the same here too. Basically, what this did was I created a line and glued it onto these points where it intersects with the geometry. Let's quickly continue drawing our rest of the sketch. I go horizontal, I find this endpoint, and I go down, look at these beautiful guidelines, and I draw up and escape. And then here I draw a line up 15 millimeters straight up over and down and escape to make sure everything is horizontal, vertically aligned. Double click a sketch element that selects an all sketch elements and hit horizontal, vertical. Beautiful. So let's exit the sketch. We know the shelling was done by 5 millimeters. Let's go to the history, use the shell command. Let's set this to 2 and press enter. Look at this, you see the sketch is updated. So this means if I now go to the sketch back and I create a center line right at the middle that goes straight up and is glued to midpoint, I now have half of a profile. I select half of the sketch profile, then a revolve body axis and go to revolve, and for visibility purpose, I just only revolve, in this case, minus 150 millimeters. I will round this corner a little bit. Then I will select this body, click on isolate. I can select these three flat faces, do a shelling by 2 millimeters. Exit the isolation mode. And then again, when I go to the first shell command for the vessel and I change here the dimension again back to 5 millimeters, you will see how everything automatically updates. A nice example of such a showcase is, for example, the cap for a water bottle, like I have here. If I go to the front view, there you can see how I created this initial sketch perfectly fitting to the initial cap, and then I built the lid that actually went over it. If I go to the history, I'm actually using rotate move command. I can right click and suppress it, so you see actually where the original stage was. Go back to the front view and then turn on section view, so we can look right into our design like a section cut. And there you can see now perfectly how the ability to create sketches that can snap to existing geometry is such a powerful tool. So you have all the control to do a really nice precision modeling. I will go back, right click and say unsuppress. So one can see this rotatable part actually rotated away.